You're watching The Big Story with me, Avni Raja. Let's get straight to the big story that we're tracking today. Now, it's just 2 weeks after the alleged criminal negligence took the lives of up to 60 children in Gorakhpur. Another shocker comes from the same hospital of horror, the BRD Medical College. A Times Network sting operation reveals that 60 more children have now died in the now infamous hospital, and that's in the last 3 days. The principal of Gorakhpur's BRD hospital has officially admitted that 42 children lost their lives in 48 hours between the 27th and the 28th of August. And our own sources confirm that 18 more children died on August 29th. That takes the death toll to 60 in the last 3 days alone. The sting also revealed rampant corruption and shortage of resources in the encephalitis ward.
हम आए थे वहाँ पे यहाँ मशरूम मस्ती जोर हुआ था हम बता रहे थे कल तब तो वहाँ से उन्होंने भेजा वार्ड नंबर 100 में
अच्छा
ठीक तो वहाँ से फिर यहाँ पे आए जो है कि ट्रीटमेंट वहाँ पर नहीं हो पा रहा था मतलब गंभीर था सीरियस उसका तबीयत
अच्छा
तो वहाँ से फिर आई सी यू में भर्ती किया तब दोपहर में आए थे
अभी क्या पोजिशन है बच्चे की
पोजिशन लगभग ठीक है मीडियम में है कुछ ज़्यादा नहीं बेनिफिट नहीं है
अच्छा एक एक बेड पे दो दो बच्चे तीन तीन बच्चे दिखाई दे रहे हैं आपके बेड बेड पे कितने बच्चे हैं
दो है
जी
दो बच्चे हैं
आप लोग जैसे रहते कहाँ पे हैं
रहते ना वहीं पे स्टेशन की बात हुआ अब इसी पर रहते हैं बरामदे में एक दो घंटे ले लिया थी उसी कहाँ रहते हैं जगह यहाँ पे गेस्ट रूम भी नहीं कहीं मिल जाए रहना पड़ता है अब रात में देखना पड़ता है उसको
बड़ी कष्ट है
गेस्ट रूम भी नहीं भैया कि मतलब रूम मिल जाए कुछ देर आदमी आराम कर ले लेकिन यहाँ पानी पीने की व्यवस्था नहीं है कुछ आदमी वही से बीमार हो रहा है ऊपर से पानी की व्यवस्था नहीं है कि आदमी पी ले बिना फ्रीजर में वहाँ पे फ्रीजर है इतना गंदगी है घुस नहीं सकते
Meanwhile, listen into what BRD Medical College's newly appointed Principal PK Singh had to say about the gross apathy going on in the hospital.
पिछले 48 hours में BRD Medical College में 42 deaths हुई हैं। इसमें NICU में 16 deaths हुई हैं और PICU में 26 deaths हुई हैं और 7 deaths जो हैं encephalitis से हैं। Rest deaths जो हैं वो other pediatric diseases से हैं। इसमें बहुत छोटे क्रिटिकल कंडीशन में बच्चे हमारे पास आ रहे हैं जो कि मात्र आधा घंटे एक घंटे सरवाइव कर रहे हैं इस वजह से और टोटल पेशेंट इस समय 342-350 के आसपास पर डे हमारे इन्वॉल्व पेशेंट हैं केवल 7 हुई हैं और जो 42 में रेस्ट डेथ्स हैं वो अदर पीडियाट्रिक डिजीजेस से हैं
All right, let's go across now to Amir, who's joining me live at this point. Amir, we know what happened earlier on in the middle of August as far as those 63 children who died were concerned, all the controversy that happened then. And now another 60 children have died just 2 weeks after those deaths due to criminal negligence took place.
Well, you see, this is not just surprising, this is also very sad and heartbreaking because it was just about 3 weeks back that we covered this story wherein more than 60 children had died there because of the lack of oxygen, the BRD Medical College in Gorakhpur. And now, just within 3 weeks of it, and after a number of tall claims made by senior functionaries within the government that everything will be taken care of, which includes the Chief Minister, the Health Minister, the Medical Education Minister, the Union Health Minister, all of them assuring that things will be taken care of, there will be no more deaths because of negligence in the BRD Medical College. Here we see that over 60 children have died because there is absolutely a lack of hygiene there, because there is crunch of resources in the BRD Medical College, in the children's ward, because there is corruption on the ground level that is quite perceptible and that is quite apparent that has been caught in these visuals that we are showing on our channel right now. So there is nothing that can explain this kind of apathy that continues within the BRD Medical College in Gorakhpur, despite tall claims made by the government. So it actually seems that the management of the BRD Medical College, the administration there, and even in the people in the government are absolutely insensitive to the requirements of the patients there. These young children losing their lives because of the apathy of the medical staff over there, and there seems to be absolutely nothing that has been done over the last 3 weeks to ensure that people get quality medical services in the BRD Medical College. And that's what our sting operation actually brings forth about the BRD Medical College in Gorakhpur.
Amir, couple of questions that are there. Firstly, last time around, we saw that there were no postmortems at all done as far as those children who died. This time around, has any postmortem been done at all?
Well, the reports that we are privy to still do not point towards any postmortem done on most of these children who lost their lives there. Obviously, this time there was no dearth of oxygen cylinders as such, but the apathy of the medical staff is quite apparent. We were privy to the fact that there were people who were going in and coming out of the ICUs and neonatal ICUs like they were just general wards. There were people who were walking in with their slippers and shoes inside, giving a go-by to whatever hygiene norms the government hospitals should adhere to. There were doctors and there were medical staff who did not care about the patients being found, 2 to 3 children being found on one bed. In fact, one bed was being allotted to 2 and more than 2 children in these ICUs. So there obviously is a clear understanding that they cannot prevent the infection from spreading further, and they cannot prevent such children's health from deteriorating if such health conditions continue to prevail. Moreover, there was no drinking water which was available in the pediatrics ward area, which actually point towards a great apathy. Then there was actually no cleanliness norms that were being adhered to inside the hospital premises, inside the wards, or just outside the hospital and these wards. Also, we saw hundreds of these relatives of patients, their attendants, sleeping inside the corridors of the hospital, inside the wards, outside the hospital. So there seems to be a complete anarchy inside the BRD Medical College, despite the assurances being given by even the Chief Minister himself. So there actually seems to be a complete disregard to the health norms and to the kind of assurances and promises that were given by the big wigs within the government itself. As far as we've seen in the BRD Medical College in Gorakhpur.
Stay with us. In fact, I want to show our viewers what Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath actually said, the shocking comment that he made.
फलानी जगह कूड़ा पड़ा हुआ है फलानी जगह पड़ा हुआ है हम लोगों के अंदर कोई इतना सिविक सेंस है भी नहीं हम करना भी नहीं चाहते सफाई करना भी नहीं चाहते हम लोग ये मानते हैं सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है नगर निगम की जिम्मेदारी है नगर पालिका की जिम्मेदारी है या ग्राम समाज की जिम्मेदारी है जैसे कि हम सभी जिम्मेदारी से एकदम मुक्त हो गए हैं हम लोगों ने अपनी जिम्मेदारी सरकार के ऊपर ठहर दी है और मुझे तो ये भी कभी कभी लगता है कि एक समय के बाद कहीं ऐसा ना हो कि लोग अपने बच्चे जैसे एक साल दो साल के होंगे तो सरकार के भरोसे छोड़ देंगे कि सरकार इन बच्चों का पालन नहीं करेगा क्योंकि मैं देख रहा हूं किस प्रकार की स्थिति हो गई हर कार्य को सरकार गाय अपने घर में रखेंगे दूध अपना बेचेंगे लेकिन सड़क पे छोड़ देंगे सरकार उनकी देखभाल करेगी
Well, Amir, we just heard what Yogi Adityanath actually said there, and I just want to quote that, saying people seem so dependent on the government these days that I feel people will soon expect us to take care of their infants once they reach 2 years of age, end of quote. And that was followed by, a kind of round of applause from the audience. So absolutely what you mentioned, absolute lack of apathy, absolute apathy coming from the government, from the hospital. We've got a new principal now, of course, but nothing seems to have changed because last time round we saw that the entire cleanliness angle, we were shown that the hospital is actually being cleaned and all of that. But now, there's the absolute, that's absolutely not the case any longer.
Well, yes, this absolutely should be quite embarrassing for the Chief Minister himself, apart from the top brass from within his party, because although the Chief Minister is not making a direct reference to the BRD deaths that we are reporting out here, but he definitely makes a comment about people, this tendency among people to rely more on government resources and less on themselves. So that clearly, you know, is unbecoming of a Chief Minister. He shouldn't have perhaps made this kind of a comment, especially around a time when already, you know, there are questions being raised on the quality of health services being provided at his own home turf. And especially the Chief Minister over the last 3 to 4 weeks has made almost 3 to 4 visits, not just to the BRD Medical College in Gorakhpur, but also to the flood-ravaged areas of his constituency. So he has consistently been watching what is happening in Gorakhpur. And despite the kind of deaths that have been reported, the kind of medical negligence that we've been highlighting, for him to be making such a statement is absolutely shameful.
Absolutely, Amir. Thank you so much for getting us all those details. Now joining me on the phone line is Dr. K.K. Agarwal, President of the Indian Medical Association. Thank you very much, Mr. Agarwal, for joining in. You know, I want your first comments on this entire issue, because we saw just a few weeks ago, we saw the what really happened, the entire controversy, how 60 children were killed. And now again, we are hearing the similar story happening just weeks later.
So it's a matter of concern. It's a matter of concern. And I personally feel that government should declare this as a public health emergency. We need to work into it. All deaths needs to be audited. If you can't do postmortem, do virtual postmortem, which is a whole body CT scan or a mini autopsy, which we call them as a medial autopsy, to find out the cause. Because you cannot allow children to die like that, number one. Number two, we need to classify children who are dying within 24 hours or after 24 hours. If they are dying within 24 hours, it is a public health hazard. That means people are coming, people are not aware, and they are delaying the diagnosis and they are coming to the hospital late. And if they are dying after 24 hours, then it is some sort of a disease where awareness needs to be created amongst the doctors. So I think it's a matter where all associations, all government and all bodies should work together to find out the cause, why it is happening. And then this phenomena that you are having more than one bed, more than one patient per bed, will add to the situation, because then you will not be able to do justice to the patient who are admitted. So only those patients, therefore all private under the Epidemic Act, government can take action and declare that all the private hospitals, a percentage of them will start treating patients, and so that the load of the medical college can only be on encephalitis.
Dr. Agarwal, you're well versed with what's happened now and what happened earlier on. Do you believe that the state government should declare this as an emergency situation?
No, if the deaths are occurring, it's a public health emergency. It's not emergency. Public health emergency means number of cases are dying. Therefore, government has they can take certain legislative decisions that only emergency patients will be admitted in the government medical college. Routine work they can defer, so that all efforts can be made to the children who are being admitted and taken care of.
But Dr. Agarwal, my question to you is the fact that, I mean, the kind of things that we've been seeing going on in the hospital, the kind of apathy we've been seeing, the kind of lack of facilities, basic facilities not being given to the patients, to the children who are there. Is it really an emergency, medical emergency, like you're saying, or is it simply the fact that there isn't enough that the hospital is doing?
No. What I am trying to say is, when you are dealing with such a phenomena which is unusual, then all your resources and efforts should be diverted to that. You can stop admitting routine patients and concentrate on these patients and try to save them.
But that's what I'm trying to understand. Is this an extraordinary situation, or is it simply a lack of?
This has to be decided by the local authorities. I have no figure how many people died last year in this particular season. If they feel number of deaths are more and they are unexplained, then all efforts have to be on that. Like in Delhi, you had dengue chikungunya. All efforts for every hospital dengue wards were declared. That government declared that every hospital will have dengue wards. So this has to be decided by the Public Health Department of Gorakhpur and the NCDC of Delhi. the NCDC and the public health department feels the situation is out of control, they can take some administrative decisions under the Indian Epidemic Act.
All right. Dr. Agarwal, request you to stay with us. Let's go across to Aishwarya now, who's joining in. Aishwarya was in Gorakhpur the first time round when 63 children were killed due to lack of oxygen. Aishwarya, take us through what really happened that time. You were there for the entire week. You covered the entire situation, what happened at the hospital. Just take us through, just review for us what happened then.
So, Avni, what this sting operation which happened recently shows us is exactly what even I covered, that there is no one to look at cleanliness. There was no one to tender to those children. In some of the wards, the doctors were missing. Another thing which was very peculiar was that many of the relatives of those children who were admitted in the encephalitis ward were allowed just outside the ward. Now, one of the main things which we should remember in encephalitis is that cleanliness is of utmost importance. Now, the hospital was making sure that some of the rooms were clean, but the number of relatives with those children, the number of doctors, also the kind of mopping that we saw on the hospital, I would say was kind of lethargic. So all this points out to the fact that no matter what the government says, no matter what the chief minister says, they clearly tell us that they are fighting this disease, they are fighting encephalitis, they are doing everything in their power. But the situation on ground is actually not in tandem with what the government authorities have been telling us.
Right. Aishwarya, stay with us. I'm going to go back to Dr. K.K. Agarwal. Dr. Agarwal, do you believe that the government is actually doing everything that they can, like they've been saying, in order to contain the entire encephalitis issue? All right, we've lost Dr. Agarwal. Let's go back to Aishwarya. Aishwarya, as far as, you know, the entire cleanliness angle is concerned, which is once again in this sting operation that we've seen has come back saying that there's a lot of, it's not at all clean, the entire hospital and all of that. That was, again, something that you covered extensively last time round. But by the end of it, we saw that there were new coats of paints being given, fans were being installed. We did see some change by the end of while you were there, and that has all again gone.
See, this was something which we were contemplating while we were on ground as to what was the exact reason behind the kind of facelift that we were seeing of the hospital. We did see regular mopping taking place because we went to the same places which we were covering for the past 1 week, and almost on the second last day we went on the same places and we could see coats, we could see whitewash happening, we could see floors being mopped, being swept. Now the question that we were asking that time was whether this will continue, and as the sting operation that has been done recently points out, that all those things were just for a day or two, and now the hospital authorities are back to the way they were before the death of those children took place.
Absolutely, Aishwarya. The other problem that, of course, you highlighted then as well, and which I don't think still continues, is the entire issue of private practice within the hospital premises as well.
There were many people who told us that when we go to the doctor, he tells us that, you know what, I will not be able to look at you here properly. Why don't you visit me at the other place? Now, this other place, which we later found out, was actually the private practices that these doctors used to do. Now, if you're a government, if you're employed in a government hospital, then you are not supposed to do private practice. But these norms are being clearly flouted by those who are currently being appointed in the BRD College now. Some sources tell us that the authorities are aware of this fact and they turn a blind eye to it, though we don't have concrete proof of this. But this is what people on ground say, that authorities are in the know of what the doctors are doing, but still they do not blink an eye.
All right, Aishwarya, stay on with us. Let's also go across to Rifat Javed, the founder, Janta Ka reporter, who's joining me on the phone line. Rifat, thanks so much for joining in. I mean, it's literally a few weeks later and we are literally seeing a repeat of what happened when the first time round the 63 children died due to lack of oxygen.
Avni, I was just listening to Dr. Agarwal and, in response to your question that, you know, whether can we, term this the deaths, alarming rise in the deaths of children as extraordinary. And I was surprised that, you know, he did not commit. I think 292 children dying in 1 month in one hospital would be extraordinary, whether it happens in the Yogi government or you know, any other government across the country. You know, I mean, we had the health minister who said, August mein bachche marte hi hain. That's the government, you know, they will say that. But 292 children dying. I mean, I just can't believe that, you know, there is no outrage on this.
You see, it's the same government, and then you know the flippant remarks about the chair from the chief minister, you know, giving homilies to the parents, and it's the same party, you know, whose leaders advise, you know, Hindu women to produce 4 children, and this is what you do. I mean, where is the state's responsibility? Whose responsibility is this to provide the world-class healthcare facilities? We are talking about, you know, creating new India. What kind of new India are we creating where we let 292 children die in 1 month? Despite all this outrage, it took your relentless coverage for them to just kind of, you know, ensure the cleanliness, the basic cleanliness in and around the hospital. And your reporter was right. You know, the cleanliness is key to prevent the encephalitis. But that didn't happen.
Right. Rifat, my colleague Aishwarya wants to come in for a question. Aishwarya, go ahead.
That, you know, cleanliness is the key. Do you also think that what happens in this particular hospital is that if an incident like this comes to the fore, and if there's a lot of media, and if we keep on talking about the same issue day in and day out, then the authorities get a little scared. And at that time, we see this cleanliness drive take place. And then once the cameras are off, once the media leaves the campus, the authorities, as well as those who are managing the hospital, go back to the way they were. Do you think that's the case here?
This is the first time I'm talking to you, so congratulations and well done, you know, in the hostile conditions that you work. I think, you know, look what happened. It was only during the time that you were reporting from there, you know, the authorities, they pulled up their socks and they got up to do what they needed to do or they should have done. I think you're right. You know, when the glare of the media goes missing, you know, the authorities go back to their old ways. That's typical Indian style. You know, this chalta hai attitude. Who cares whether, you know, there are 61 children die in 71 hours. I think, you know, also partly, you know, that's a larger conversation that we as media need to have, that our own apathy towards, you know, sort of giving coverage to the health issues. I mean, I personally hold myself responsible. Like during the assembly election, I was in Gorakhpur, but it didn't occur to me that, you know, we also needed to cover this aspect. So we only wake up to the reality when there is, you know, the huge number of deaths. And the rest of the year, we just don't pay enough attention to the health sector. And it's in shambles. You see what happened in Jodhpur, in Rajasthan today. You know, and this happens almost every day. Only when somebody catches it on camera, it gets reported, then we wake up to the reality that everything is not well. So we have to make, you know, health issue as part of our regular reporting. And it's great that you have a channel like yourself who is actually giving attention to the, you know, the human issues other than just the politics.
Right. And Rifa, just quickly to extend Aishwarya's point, also the fact that, you know, it was Yogi Adityanath who visited the hospital during that time. I think he made 2 or 3 visits, if I'm not wrong. And of course, the entire hospital was given a facelift when he visited.
Well, I mean, I wouldn't take his visit very seriously because, you know, and I have spoken on your channel itself that on 13th of August, I remember he was in, and actually I will agree with me, he was in Gorakhpur, you know, with his entourage and the entire paraphernalia. And on the same day, you know, it just left me utterly shocked that while he was expected to pay attention to what was going wrong in that hospital, he was busy sending circulars to all the thanas and police stations in UP to ensure that they should actually organize a grand celebration of Janmashtami. I mean, this guy's priority is wrong. He has his priorities utterly wrong. I'm not blaming him just because he comes from a particular party. I'm saying the fact that we are in this mess is because of the collective failures of the successive government. But now that we have woken up to this reality and we have highlighted it, where is his priority? I mean, the government is behaving like a headless chicken. You know, we don't know who the guilty is. You know, the minister passes the buck saying, August mein bachche mar rahe hain. You know, you go and start suspending, you know, officers en masse. We don't even know. You know, the district magistrate gives clean sheet to certain doctors. The chief secretary who reports to the chief minister finds the same officers guilty. So we don't know what is happening here. I'm absolutely confused.
All right. Thanks, Rifat, for joining in. Thanks, Aishwarya, as well. A lot of questions still need to be answered. There are several people who must answer us, including the UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, UP Health Minister Siddharth Nath Singh, UP Medical Education Minister Ashutosh Tandon, as well as the BRD College Administration. That's it on this edition of The Big Story. Thanks for watching.